AI development is simply not what it used to be. As someone who has developed and sold my first AI project back in 2018, I can assure you that today success in this field requires a completely different skill set. So in this video, I will reveal the three key areas that I'm learning as an AI developer in 2023 that not only helped me to stay ahead of the game, but also to consistently generate around 10k a month in profit from selling different AI projects. Let's dive in. Number 1. Software architecture. Yes, you've heard that right. Architecture, not even development. As an AI developer, I am no longer even learning AI development itself. Instead, I am learning design patterns and architectural styles that are essential to designing maintainable and scalable systems. So what does it even have to do with AI? Well, first of all, I believe that very soon GPT models and autonomous agents will be able to handle most of the development by themselves. We have already seen projects like GPT Engineer and Small AI that can develop and even debug their own code. If you ask ChatGPT, it can literally spit out any sorting algorithm in 3 seconds. All of these algorithms took me months to master, and even right now I can barely recall the difference between bubble and selection sorts. But where autonomous agents and GPT models fall short, however, is at reasoning and design work. Design work is valued much higher because it goes beyond mere knowledge and requires a thorough understanding of the domain and context about the task at hand. There are no right or wrong answers. Everything that architecture entails is a trade-off. Think about Tesla, for example. It can easily take you from destination A to destination B without your direct involvement, but it can decide for you where you want to go. The same goes for the development of large code bases in AI projects. Even if there were no token limits, there is no way you can communicate all the context about your problem to AI. We incorporate so much information in our minds that it's simply not possible to put it all in words. So while I think in the near future it will be possible to outsource development of a project to AI, I would never even think about outsourcing design and architecture of a big project. I do sometimes consult with GPT-4 on certain design aspects, but doing so still requires me knowing the right questions to ask. And secondly, AI models are no longer trained from scratch for each and every project. Just a few years ago, it was common for me to build a new model for each specific use case. Today, I wouldn't even think about building a model without first considering commercial or open source solutions. This means that our code bases must be more adaptable and maintainable than ever. We must be able to easily switch from one model to another in case if a better solution becomes available. Moreover, many of my clients already have some sort of infrastructure set up, and as an AI developer, I must make sure that the AI solution does not conflict with their existing systems. Some resources that I highly recommend for learning software architecture are the book Fundamentals of Software Architecture by Mark Richards and Neil Ford, which I'm currently reading, and a software architecture course on Coursera. Next up, I'm learning Edge AI. Edge AI is a process of integrating and running AI directly on local devices like smartphones or IoT. If you had a chance to look at the most recent Apple presentation, even our watches can now run language models like Siri locally. And although Siri is probably still far behind from the latest Transformer models, the trend is pretty clear. We have so much extra compute in our devices that running AI models is the only reasonable way to utilize all this power. This has a tremendous potential to revolutionize how we interact with technology. Transformer models can easily call third-party APIs and take actions on our behalf. So, just imagine if you could not only run ChatGPT locally on your iPhone, but also allow it to control your favorite apps like Uber or Twitter. Just imagine if we could make a social media post or order a taxi without even needing to touch our phones. If this was the case, we would not even need touch screens because we would be able to do anything that we do on our smartphones directly from our Apple watches. So I'm definitely keeping an eye on CoreML, which is Apple's machine learning framework, because it's only a matter of time when they add the latest Transformer models and Stable Diffusion. A book that I'm reading on Edge AI is called AI at the Edge. And finally, I'm learning web development. The most most important takeaway that I have discovered over the last few years of AI development is that around 95% of all AI projects also require some form of user interface to monitor or run the model. It is very rare nowadays to encounter a project that runs only on a backend without displaying any information. Moreover, the implementation of such backend projects is already handled by products like AutoML by Google, which allow anyone to upload their data and create a machine learning model without any AI expertise. So, especially with generative AI, I believe that the success of your project relies more heavily on the convenience of your user interface rather than on the performance of your model. And the most ubiquitous way to allow anyone to interact with your model is, of course, through the browser. Just think about it. Anything that has a screen nowadays also has a browser. Even my ebook does. So it only makes sense to develop UIs where most people will be able to access them at all times. I am constantly keeping an eye on the latest web frameworks to check if any of them release any exciting features. However, for now I am mostly focusing on Next.js, which is a framework built on top of React. The best resource for web development is of course YouTube, where you can find thousands of free courses or project walkthroughs. Additionally, for simpler user interfaces, you can leverage Python libraries like Streamlit or Gradio, which are sometimes more than enough for internal projects. For more details, check out my last video in the description on how to build your first AI-driven web app from scratch. So, as you might have noticed, I mostly learn technologies that help me integrate existing AI solutions rather than build AI from scratch. There is no way I could possibly train a more powerful model than what OpenAI provides. But what I could do, however, is help businesses leverage OpenAI to drive growth and profits. And yes, data privacy is often a major concern with such projects. But if you go to Microsoft Azure, you can find out that their OpenAI service actually does not even share data with OpenAI itself. This means that you would be running OpenAI models just like if you were running any other open source model on Azure, which is what most companies concerned with privacy still revert to. And if you are curious on why I personally think it makes no sense to learn AI development itself, make sure to watch this video next, where I will share a lot more insights on how this field evolved over the years. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.